Did you find what you were looking for in the box? Who were you before you came in here, Quarters? You always watching the room, always watching everything.
What are you asking what I used to do?
Yeah.
I'll tell you, but I need another favor.
Fuck that.
All right, don't do it.
All right, I'm listening. What's the favor this time?
I need a piece of metal, about 3 inches wide, round, smooth.
Oh, no problem. I hit the Home Depot, and I'll be right back, okay?
You give me that piece of metal, I might be able to get you out of here.
I'm still here, you bastards.
Over your head. If he drops it, shoot it.
Well, you could get out of the way.
No problem. Just give me the password.
Oh, yeah.
I like your pretty boy, buddy. Does he like the party?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, like it's 1999. Don't you?
Oh, you don't know the password.
Then
there's a penalty.
Shoot them, man. Jesus, I thought you were a Democrat.
knew it wouldn't take long, but I couldn't get to it. The tide was up. Chuck! Chuck!
The prisoners, they listen to you. For some reason, they look to you like you're the leader. I got news for you. And here, you're the leader.
Five or ten volumes. Crush him up.
And I got another guy in the commissary. Last meal Iceman eats before he fights. We mix it in. Just enough to slow him down. Fuck him up.
He'll still fight. But it won't be the same. That'll be just enough to give you the edge. You got it?
You do that, I'm gonna break you up into pieces. I can take this guy and I don't need no help. You understand that?
Hey, we're just trying to give you a little something extra, man. We got a lot of money on this table.
I may not be a real good guy, but I ain't no chicken shit either. You remember that?
Take him down.
In that place, I didn't think I was gonna make it a week.
Come on, you motherfuckers! You wanna eat today, you fucking piece of shit? Hey, you white trash piece of shit! You think you're fucking special, white fish? Button that top button! Let's go, move! Are you fucking eyeballing me? Don't eyeball fuck me, asshole! I'll fucking kill you! I'll keep my eye on you, you white piece of shit! But don't fucking eyeball me, boy! I'll fucking skull fuck you! Step forward! Turn to the left. Step forward to Chow. Let's go. Come on. Hey, fish, straight ahead. Straight ahead, fucker. Let's go.
All the wrong people knew who I was anyway, so I figured I'm just gonna put up a flag and hope a friend sees it.
Please.
I fucking told you, man. Gladiator school's on.
I got 10 on Gonzalez.
Shit, I got that action. Williams gonna fuck him up.
Come on. Little something we do to keep it interesting. That's supposed to fight anyway. Who you got?
I'm with you, Lieutenant Gonzalez.
Attaboy. Sergeant?
I got Williams.
Of course you do.
Come on.
Shit. I know Fuego.
Fucking Gonzalez. Tip of that asshole.
To say, John, tell me what you want me to do. You want me to take you out of here? Just let you run away? See how far you could get?
Why would you do such a foolish thing?
On the day of my judgment, when I stand before God and he asks me, why did I kill one of his true miracles? What am I going to say? That it was my job. It's my job.
You tell God the Father it was a kindness you done. I know you're hurting in word. I can feel it on you. But you ought to quit on it now. I want it to be over and done with. I do. I'm tired, boss. Tired of being on the road, lonely as a sparrow in the rain. I'm tired of never having me a buddy to be with. Tell me where we's going to, coming from, or why. Mostly I'm tired of people being ugly to each other. I'm tired of all the pain I feel and hear in the world every day. There's too much of it.
Well, we told you today's flight would be special. That's William Bedford, a.k.a. Billy Bedlam.
The mass murderer?
The same. He caught his wife in bed with another man, left her alone, drove four towns over to his wife's family's house, killed her parents, her brothers, her sisters, even her dog.
Scan him.
And who is that good-looking brother on screen?
Nathan Jones, a.k.a. Diamond Dog, former general of the Black Guerrillas. He blew up a meeting of the National Rifle Association saying, and I quote, they represented the basest negativity of the white race. He wrote a book in prison called Reflections in a Diamond Eye. New York Times called it a wake-up call for the black community. They're talking to Denzel for the movie.
Cold store number one.
This one's done it all. Kidnapping, robbery, murder, extortion.
Foxtrot Charlie, perimeter is secure. You are clear to release.
His name is Cyrus Grissom, a.k.a. Cyrus the Virus. 39 years old, 25 of them spent in our institutions. But he's bettered himself inside, earned 2 degrees, including his Juris Doctor. He also killed 11 fellow inmates, incited 3 riots, and escaped twice. Likes to brag that he killed more men than cancer.
Okay, open wide.
Fucking incredible how lucky some assholes get.
Jeez Louise, you gonna see any of that?
$35,000. That's what he left me.
Dollars?
Yep.
Holy shit, that's great. That's like winning the sweepstakes. Isn't it?
Dumb shit, what do you think the government's gonna do to me? Take a big wet bite out of my ass is what?
Poor Barry. Terrible fucking luck, huh?
Crying shame. Some people really got it awful. Andy, you nuts. Keep your eyes on your mop, man. Andy.
Well, all right, you're gonna pay some taxes, but you'll still end up with...
Oh, what? Yeah. Maybe enough to buy a new car, and then what? I gotta pay tax on the car. Repair, maintenance, goddamn kids pestering you to take them for a ride all the time. Then at the end of the year, you figure the tax wrong, you gotta pay them out of your own pocket. I tell you, Uncle Sam, He puts his hand in your shirt and squeezes your tit till it's purple. The man never gets a break. That's the thing.
You said
Rich gets himself killed.
Keep talking.
No.
Some brother.
Shit.
Hey!
Mr. Hadley, do you trust your wife?
Oh, that's funny. You're gonna look funnier sucking my dick with no teeth.
What I mean is, do you think she'd go behind your back, try to hamstring you?
Pull up. You see me, Captain. Come on.
Shit, biscuit. This is New York City 1.
All right, let's get a move
New
on.
York City 2.
Only 15 hours of daylight left. There you go. Get out of my rocks here, boss. Whew, sure as hot. Think it's gonna rain later?
Now, what you want?
What I want? What makes you think I want something?
My daddy told me when motherfuckers start talking about the weather, keep your hand on your wallet. Now, what you want?
You know, your daddy must have been a wise man. A hell of a man.
Cut the shit and tell me what you want, Claude.
You still got that map?
Yeah, I still got it. Why?
Well, if you're thinking about booking it, I want in. I think we can make it.
We? Hey, ain't you the one told me wasn't no we? Now you want to be we again, huh? What happened? We get some bad news in that letter back there, nigga?
Look, my cousin Melvin is a lawyer, and he filed an appeal on my behalf.
On your behalf? What happened to we, Claude? What happened to we?
Ray, the appeal was denied.
Well, I'm glad.
Then Daisy went and fell for Melvin. Now they ain't engaged to be married. Can you believe that?
That's hard to believe. Look, he a big, successful New York lawyer, and you down here with a bright picture in the cotton industry. Let me figure it out for you. Eeny, meeny, miny, Melvin!
What's he doing that for?
Because he's a freak.
Hey, Sasquatch! Someone's here to see you!
Not too smart on your part.
Hey!
How's the headbanging coming? You're bleeding, just so you know. People have told me that you and I look a lot alike, so I wanted to see for myself. I'm gonna take a piss.
You scared him away, dumb shit.
Bitch now, bitch.
Oh, my cracker. Laying the boot to the big nigga, give it up.
Don't use that word around me. It's ugly and racist.
He's funny too, man.
All right, listen here, player, all right? We want you to join up with us, not me, because them niggas are gonna tear you.
I said don't talk that way around me.
Get up. Come on. Get some of that.
Let's kill it.
No, I got it.
In case.
Frank.
Honey, you don't sound like Frank. Don't sweat it, I know. I drove with Frank. I'll watch your back.
Better than you watched his, I hope.
Still here. Well, I guess I gotta work a little harder.
Get back to your car, prisoner.
sure know how to make friends.
Case, this is mirror glass. No one can see it, so you might want to take the mask off. Unless you like it under there.
How the hell is driving that van? What?
You're better looking than the last, Frank. If you crash.
General Hummel's coming on board with the security inspection team.
Yes, sir. Sir, it's an honor having you, sir.
Have mystery mounds on Wednesday.
I can't taste it. You just need that habit. What's the movie this weekend?
Some cowboy piece of shit.
At least they could show us a gangster movie.
I may have found a way out of here. Looking at something? The way I figured, the cell block's really getting old. The moist air is corroding the concrete. And the salt is rusting the metal. And I took a nail clipper. I was digging around the grill in the back of the cell. I think with some work, I could dig that grill out of there. Enlarge the hole and get into the utility corridor, which leads to the top of the cell block, and maybe out on the roof.
How we had the hole all working on it?
Well, we can tear the cans out of magazines. No one will miss those, and make cardboard out of them. Paint grills on that and put it back in the hole. Maybe partially obscure it with a towel or a bath rope or whatever.
Bir şeyler bulduk.
Ne bu?
Haşiş.
Ne bu? Bu şişi nedir buldun?
Baksan.
Bu haşişle ne oluyor?
Sıratının efendisini çok iyi biliyorum.
Bu haşişle ne oluyor? Haşişi nereden buldun?
Bir şey bilmiyor.
What about all these broken bones? Well, they may be due to a blunt trauma. But you need to temper that with the knowledge that those self-same fractures could have occurred several years after death as a result of a cave-in of the grave walls.
You don't have to be in practice for 20 years to recognize a skull violently crushed to the size of a grapefruit.
Son, I have got the forensic expert's report sitting in front of me here. And according to all my scientific friends, who are very knowledgeable in this area, it's just not all that clear on that point.
You've got probably a couple of dozen or so indigent inmates buried in an old pauper's graveyard. Anything else, I think, is pure speculation.
Paupers don't die in pieces, do they, Dr. Gregory?
I will put it to you, Mr. Partridge, that this board is quite capable of questioning its witnesses, and that this whole procedure could just as easily have been a closed hearing.
The Wilkinson Home for Boys held 780 youthful offenders, housed in five separate units. From the outside, the facility resembled what those who ran it wanted it to resemble. Some kind of nice school, a university. Michael, Tommy, John, and I were assigned to the second floor of Group C. We each had a private 12-foot room. I'd been in my room less than an hour when the panic set in. It doesn't take very long to know how tough a person you are or how strong you can be. I knew from my first day at Wilkinson that I was neither tough nor strong.
Hello, Carcaterra. Toss your clothes on the floor.
Here?
What do you expect, in a dressing room? We don't have any. I'll lose the clothes.
Hey, Jan.
What's up, Sugar Plum?
I met this guy today, Shamed Head. Earl Copen, you know what I'm talking about?
Earl Copen? Sugar Plum, Earl Copen and I go all the way back. We were even cellmates together years ago. I'll tell you something I worry about Earl these days. I'm just worried that that Peckerwood's just gonna burn his old ass out.
What do you mean?
What I mean, all the rage, the anger. You can't come in here with all that same rage and anger that you had when you was 20 and not think it's going to blow out your candlelight. I mean, when I first met Earl Copen was one of the most dysfunctionary, confused, angry human beings that I've ever seen or met in my whole life. I remember this one time that Earl had this disagreement with this big old boy who wanted his ass. Earl wasn't going to give it up. I'm going to tell you something about Earl Copen. Earl Copen had a set of balls on him from the day one he got in his joint. He knew he couldn't handle this boy one-on-one, so he went up on a catwalk, and he got one of them mop buckets, one of them big old steel mop buckets, and he filled it up with water.
Yeah.
Skip, please.
Excuse me, sir. Could I keep... Wait a minute. I'm not a troublemaker.
Skip.
Skip! Skip! Okay, no more hitting. Did you hear what I just said?
Skip!
No more hitting.
Skip!
All right, turn around. Skip. You want to stay late tonight? I said turn around. Okay, let's get out of here. Come on, Silver.
Skip.
Harry, I'm freaking.
Skip!
Giddy up! So long, suckers! Hey, Harry! He thinks he's a horse! Help me! Harry!
Don't hit him! Don't hit him! Please! He's sick! He's having a fit! See, he don't have his fit pills! He's got them! See, where's your fit? He's got one!
Vietnam, please, man, don't hit him! Harry! Help me, Harry!
Skip!
Harry!
Skip!
Huh?
Skip!
Huh?
Oh, shit! Skip!
Harry!
Skip!
I must have read this book about a dozen times. If I had my time again, if I could start over, like rereading this book, there'd be someone I'd sit down and talk to. I'd talk some sense into them. Tell them how things really are. But I can't. That man's long gone. And I'm all that's left.
Where is he?
But do you know something? I'm free now. Like my little girl.
Free? You've got an imagination.
Imagination's what protects us. It's what keeps us alive.
You speak Russian?
A little, but only one sentence.
Well, let me have it, mate.
Я вас люблю.
Я вас
люблю.
Люблю. Я вас люблю. Я вас люблю. What's it mean?
I love you.
Love you? What bloody good is that?
I don't know. I wasn't going to use it myself.
Absolutely forbidden to cross it, you know that.
Yeah, but my baseball rolled over there. How am I gonna get my baseball?
You first ask permission.
Oh, okay. Get my baseball!
Stop this nonsense, get over the wire! Immediately!
Okay.
You stay there. Out of the way.
Out. Thanks, so Reddit.
Trying to be gentle, mate.
You fucking idiot. Rip into it. Slash it off. The other one.
You're not gonna get me for this later, are you?
Just get on with it, you fucking fairy. Rip into it. Get a screw, would you?
You've got to stop the bleeding, okay? You're going to need cold water. You've got to get yourself into the shower, right?
You talking to me now, are you? Hey? After all I've done for you, I took you from tears to fucking glory, and you do this to me. I'm not angry at you, Jim. You just broke my heart, that's all.
Couldn't get out of Hayes Division, hey? You practically ran down and carried me out. Haven't
you?
Look at
you. Get him out.
I told you I'd get out, didn't I? Have a look who's fucking leaving, boss.
Get him out!